Okay, yeah, slam it. That's fine.
So Joe, when you get to the shippers and consignees, most of the time, do you have to take all these panels off or some of them?
Well, it all depends what you're hauling. If you're, if I'm picking up a steel coil, which is just one large rolled up piece of steel, right about 46, 45,000 pounds, I'll set up a single rack in the center of my trailer here, but I only take out three panels, and then up top I have to flip the tarp over and open up the three bows, so when they load it, they can see what they're putting on there. And if I'm getting like a set of what do you call the steel coils on skids, which we'll be laying down, I'll probably have to open up more of them because it'll be a different load. I'll have to get unloaded from the side with like a forklift. And so I have to open up more panels. But if I'm doing like a dock lift and I'm just backing in and they just drive the forklift on, and I don't have to open none of the panels, but I'll have to open up all the bows.
So the panels, this is a panel.
Yes.
How does that panel come out? Does it slide up?
It slides up after I unfasten all these bungees on the sides and you flip your tarp over. Okay. You'll be able to slide these out and out. And then they just slide right up, right out, real easy.
Now this tarp, does it come all the way off?
You could take it all the way off, but where I get loaded and we don't have to take it all the way off, but it is possible for it to take it all the way off, but we don't. We just undo the one side 90% of the time. That we don't have to take off the other side. So we're always getting loaded either from the top or on the side or in the rear.
Okay. So you mentioned the bows. Those go across the top.
Yes.
Those come off, or do you have to take those off?
You don't have to take them off completely, but you can lift them out. That's what they are stuck down inside these posts here.
Okay.
That holds them from one end to the other. So when we go to open up, we only have to, majority of the time, have to open up the one side. So we just flip all those bows over, overlap each other, and just swing them out of the way.
Are they heavy?
No, they're not heavy at all, no.
All right. No. So since you go into the same shippers and consignees a lot, you must build up relationships with the people there. What's that like? Do you get to know a lot of the people by name?
Yeah, we do. We get to know majority of the people in there, and we have pretty good relationships. We know what's going on in some of their lives. They know what's going on in my life, and we know each other by name. You know, we're probably friends with a few of them on Facebook also.
Yeah. Well, Joe, I really appreciate your time today. Thanks for answering my questions.
Thank you.
Have
nice
a good
meeting
day.
You.
Nice to meet you too. So I noticed that you have three axles.
Yes.
What's the purpose of that?
The purpose of it is to carry more weight.
Okay.
I can gross out at 120,000 pounds. The truck and trailer empty, I weigh about 37,000, so I can put almost 83 on the deck, depending upon fuel and so forth like that. I get a little bit more weight on my steers and my drives. I can put up to 46,000 on my drives. My trailers, I get 20,000 per axle. It's a 10-foot spread. And we have the ability that if I'm running a legal load, I can actually, there's a box on the side where I can lift that axle and just leave it up constantly. Or there's a switch on the dash where I can drop and lower that axle.
Okay.
It kind of helps in turning and so forth, wear and tear on the tires.
Okay. So what, can you show me what you're talking about right there?
There's actually two boxes on here. The first one is my weight gauges.
Mm-hmm.
And these weight gauges will correspond with another one I have on the dash that'll kind of level everything out and tell me where I'm, if I got my weights close to being right. And then I got this box here, that this lever, it goes up and down, and that'll raise and lower, and I can actually lock that axle up.
Okay.
So
Are there any other differences to this type of trailer? Somebody would want to know about?
Not a whole lot. With the Conestoga trailers, you got to be a little more careful when you get side loaded. Mm-hmm. You know, people bumping into it. Because this is on a slider system, yeah. If they get bumped into, it can damage them and cause a lot of problems, you know, going back and forth. I am running a little bit taller than what the covered wagons do. Mm-hmm. So you got to watch overhangs, you know, tree branches going down streets and stuff like that a little bit more. But it's really not that bad. I enjoy it a lot. It's, you know, there's definitely a challenge when it comes to the hauling the heavier loads and the weight placement. With these three axle trailers, the trailer essentially acts like a teeter totter. So you have to kind of balance it out. And I can actually put 41,000 on at the landing gear and 41,000 at that middle axle. Okay. And it keeps everything level and legal.
All right. So,